We're here with Geddis' 2017 STI. It's a really special car, actually. He was one of my first clients when I started this company 5 years ago. Some joker named Alex introduced me to him.
I had a BRZ back then, I think. Or wait, did I have this?
BRZ.
Yeah, I had a BRZ, and I think I brought it to you because I wanted you to part it out.
Yeah,
because I bought this.
You wanted something with more power.
So buy BRZ.
It was tasteful. It looked good.
Yeah, it was slow.
Yeah, well, they all are. We basically saw this car when it was stock, man, and you came in for what you did, the intake and the coilovers.
Intake, coilovers, blow-off valve.
Yeah, blow-off valve.
And exhaust and downpipe. It was funny because I was never really into speed like that, and I was always into like making the car look flashy and stuff until I rode in Andrew's car. And that literally changed. I think literally the next week I was like, flux fuel kit, this, that, and the other. I was sick of being one of the guys that couldn't compete with some of the other guys that you had that you had on the team on the adrenaline blacklist.
Yeah, whenever we all start racing and then it separates, the pack separates into entry level cars and the faster cars.
Yeah, and I was tired of being in the back. Me and Angie in the back.
It's simple. It's a very simple build. We do a lot of Subarus. They're actually pretty easy cars if you just take, you know, the few Achilles heels out of, you know, the equation. And they definitely thrive on E85. They love corn. They sound great. Probably one of my favorite things about this car is the way it sounds. Insert exhaust clip there. It sounds great, man. It's a very unique sound. Everybody always does, you know, they keep the unequal length headers and run, you know, axle back and then HKS SSQB.
Yeah.
Every Subaru, you know, you get the rumble and then the high-pitched whistle. So this one, it's definitely got a nice, unique sound to it. It's very tastefully done. Geddis here actually has great taste. He'll pull up to dinner in a suit with a cheetah shirt underneath it and a gold chain, and you're just like,
yeah.
So you get the anime stickers and the carbon fiber accents. Nothing's overdone. The hood's actually got a red tint over the carbon fiber. It's just everything's so tastefully done. It used to have gold wheels on it. Even the teal wheels, they pop.
We got to shout out Jeff at Paint Pros.
Yeah, Jeff at Paint Pros.
He got the hood right.
There's a lot of people who've had their hands on this car. We got Chris Jameson over at Malahini Customs at the air suspension. And it's crazy because I'm not really into air suspension, but in the right application, it's...
Quick story. I actually didn't tell Ryan I was doing it until after it was done. Because I knew he was going to be upset about it. I was like, I didn't want him to try to talk me out of it. So I did it. And I was like, oh. But and I was actually kind of nervous. I was like, by the way.
You started a trend because Dustin did it right after.
I was like, I bagged it. Oops.
We've got, Jack's Fab Shop. Good friends over there. Justin Ellis, a good buddy of mine. Did the intercooler, custom front mount kit. It's pretty big core, actually. Most people run the Mishimoto or the Cobb. Or even the ETS kit.
Keep it local.
We try to keep all the business local here.
Overall, this car means a lot to me because there's been a lot of times where I rode solo in this car by myself, took a plunge into, you know, a different industry and whatnot, and a lot of blood, sweat, and tears went into this car. A lot of me crying went into this car because it's not fun being broke. The thing I love the most about the car is the relationships I built off of it. I know that sounds corny and stuff, but it is corny. But legitimately, this car has brought a lot of people into my life that I didn't know before. And now they're all like one big, you know, big happy family. And I enjoy that. So that was like the biggest thing. A lot of people are like, car community sucks, but it doesn't suck to me.